After 14 years of applying, my good friend Chris Nowak has drawn one of Colorado's most coveted tags, Rocky Mountain Bighorn Sheep. We had planned all summer for me to join him on this hunt, but because of back spasms, I can't go. Fortunately for Chris, our mutual friend Brad Billingsley is taking several days off of work to replace me and do what he can to help Chris.
Let's go find a ram.
Things could change pretty quickly up here.
Nobody who says this is easy is lying.
They're running.
Oh, I'm sick right now. I'm just sick.
Victory begins with a single step. It is formed in strategy, tested by adversity, and forged with an iron will. But for victory to be pure, it must be earned. Join Willie Schmidt on an epic quest to rediscover the last, best, pure hunts that are accessible to everyone, if they're willing to go the extra mile.
Pure Hunting is brought to you by Browning, the best there is. Spot Hog, the world's toughest archery products. Clean Shot, the makers of Knockout, the frustration-free lighted knock. Fox Pro, high-performance game calls. And by the Swing Blade, with two blades in one to open game like a zipper by Outdoor Edge. The new Barnett Razor, razor light, razor fast. Bloodsport Arrows, we're not afraid to show you blood. And Tenzing, go further, hunt longer.
It's the day before the season opener for Colorado Bighorn Sheep. Chris and Willie's mutual friend, Brad Billingsley, is joining Chris as he hunts Unit S-12, just outside the town of Buena Vista. Chris has been scouting all summer, but hopes that one last scout today will allow him to put a nice ram to bed before opening day.
So that ram standing up on that middle rock facing us.
Oh yeah.
He's probably just legal, isn't he?
Now hopefully there's supposed to be like six or eight running down here with two really nice almost full curls, so I haven't seen them yet or found them, but.
Where's all your big brothers?
It's good to see sheep on the first morning.
That's a good sign.
After watching this young ram for a while, they decide to head to higher elevations to find a more mature one.
Since the weather's held out pretty good, it was nice we were able to get up here and up in the top of 12 mile.
What are we at, about 12,000 feet?
Yeah.
Another 1,500 plus to get up to the top, huh?
Yep.
Where have you seen the sheep in your scouting?
Mostly in 12 mile. I've seen them on this ridge. Hopefully they're just laying up in one of those bowls, and tomorrow morning, that's where we'll want to be.
Good. So I've got my my rain gear and some warmth.
Okay.
Because things could change pretty quickly up here.
Yeah.
Summer afternoons in Colorado's high country are known to produce quickly building thunderstorms. They're typically short-lived, but fierce. With lightning, rain, high winds, and the possibility of hail or even snow, they make the hiking conditions above treeline very dangerous.
Well, this is the playground, at least one of them.
Wow, it's big country.
Well, let's see if we can't find them.
Look over this way.
Bighorn sheep are masters at blending into their surroundings. They have incredible eyesight, equal to 10 power binoculars, and they often spot hunters before being seen themselves. They are legendary rock climbers and can scale tremendously steep terrain very quickly, allowing them to escape predators.
You see the elk there, Brad?
Oh yeah. Wow, there's gotta be a few hundred, huh?
Chris and Brad glass for the rest of the afternoon, but don't spot anything other than elk. They head back to lower country near the end of the day for some final scouting.
Let's go back down this road. You know where we saw that little ram this morning?
Yep.
Hey, right there. Five.
They're right there. Oh my God.
Unbelievable. We spent an entire day above tree line. They're right down here by the river.
They're back by another river. All young rams, nothing real big.
Yeah.
It's a good band of rams, though.
Yeah, it's cool to see them.
The guys are excited about spotting a herd of young rams and head off to set up camp.
We can camp here and we can glass this whole ridge from here. This isn't a horrible view.
Feels good to have hot food in us.
Yeah, well, I'll bring some warmer clothes tomorrow. It's amazing though, you know, you're hiking 11, 12, you're like, oh man, this is good, you know. That last, like, 13 to 14 is killer, you know?
Yeah.
We gotta keep low.
They're running.
What? We got a little weather moving in.
I can't see anything.
It's the opening morning of Chris's Bighorn sheep hunt, and he and Brad are up early to glass the lower river country, where they saw the band of young sheep last night.
You know, it was good that we did see some rams down here in the river. We didn't see any up high yesterday. Doesn't mean they're not there. We'll see, but it's here. 2 months of training, 2 months of scouting, too much. It's all coming down to, starts today, so.
They pull over to glass the hillsides, hoping to spot a ram amongst the sheep-colored rocks.
All right, come on. Now, where is the sheep? Well, nothing's jumping out at me. These sheep, I'll tell you, that's just here today, gone tomorrow. And
they're in there. They're just challenging to find. We either stick around and keep looking here or get up to the high country.
Let's go up high before the weather turns bad.
All right, well, before we go, I've got a little totem from the sheep gods.
Come on, buddy, rub him. Well, we're gonna go find his daddy.
Chris and Brad head back up to 12 Mile, hoping to spot the rams Chris found on his earlier scouting trips.
Go take a little walk over yonder. All right, sheep hunt.
Sheep live at high elevations, preferring the safety of steep, treacherous country. For hunters, just getting to where the sheep live requires long hikes with large elevation gains.
Halfway there.
Nobody who says this is easy is lying.
The guys carry colored paper and arrows to aid Brad in directing Chris during a stalk on a ram.
All right, we're on top of the ridge just north of Weston Pass. And you can see we got a little weather moving in, but hopefully it's not gonna be too bad. But we're gonna sneak over the ridge and start glassing down into these bowls. Gotta keep low.
Shortly after they set up to glass, the clouds start to roll in and the sky continues to darken until visibility becomes almost non-existent.
It's getting dangerous, we better call it. Tomorrow's another day and we're gonna be after them.
Day two of the hunt starts out clear and the hunters have high hopes of spotting a mature ram.
Let's go find a ram.
Chris had heard about an observation spot from other hunters who had been in this unit before.
Well, Brad, I think we found it. Nice little observatory they got here.
There's a reason that someone's gone to this much effort. There's gotta be sheep up here. Look at all the country you could glass.
They glass from the spot for over an hour, but still don't locate any sheep.
Should we head out?
Yeah, we'll go over to 4 Mile. And then we'll work our way back this way from camp. We hit 4 Mile, 12 Mile, hit this again, and then we'll hit the pass again tonight.
We just gotta cover ground until we find something.
Right.
All right, well, let's move out. Let's get moving.
On the drive up to tree line, the weather takes a turn for the worse, again.
Good thing we're not up on top now.
Yeah.
You can't see anything.
Yeah.
You can't see a cloud.
No.
Waiting out the rainstorm.
But it doesn't let up.
Oh, Brad, this just doesn't look like it's gonna break and give us really any glassing opportunities.
That would stroll.
Brad and Chris are disappointed to lose another afternoon to the weather. But with 5 days remaining in the hunt, there's still plenty of time to find sheep. The dawn brings clear weather, and the guys decide to head back toward Weston Pass. Today is Brad's last day to help Chris, so the two hunters are hoping to spot some rams early.
There's a bunch of elk.
Oh yeah. Why couldn't they be sheep?
The guys arrive at bowl number 2 of 12 Mile and begin glassing.
What's that down there? Yeah, I think that's a mountain goat, Brad. Just absolutely gorgeous. Looks like a nice billy too, like 8, 9, maybe even 10 inches.
You know you're up high when you're above the mountain goats.
Yeah.
tells me that we're doing the right thing. We just keep our effort up, we're gonna run into the sheep.
All right, we're starting to get some weather. We've heard a little bit of thunder and seen some lightning, so I think we're gonna have to bail out again today. Lightning just gets me scared, I'm getting too old.
The men pack it in and head down to say their goodbyes.
Hi, man. I think this is where the road ends for me.
Yeah, it looks like this is gonna last for a while, so unfortunately we didn't get one stalk and we didn't even see a ram.
They gotta be in there. They're just hidden in some little pocket. You got some time though.
Yeah.
Hi, man. Take care, buddy.
Hey, yeah. Okay, have a safe drive home.
All right, see ya.
Yeah.
Later that afternoon, the weather breaks, so Chris decides to glass from one of the lower roads. He wants to search the opposite side of the bowl that he and Brad hunted in the morning.
Sheep! It's about time.
Yeah, they're the nice chocolate ones, you know? They've got a nice chocolate color.
Oh, shoot! Something spooked them. What the?
They're going up the scree shield, going right up to the saddle. What's that up there on the side of that green patch? Oh, 200! My anticipation was pretty high, and then all of a sudden I see the hunters and the rams blow out and going possibly over the saddle to where we were this morning. So now it's just a chess match of what am I going to do in the morning. Tomorrow's another day. Rams, about 200 yards. I can just get up here another 50 yards. All right, this is it.
It's day 4 of Chris's Bighorn sheep hunt. He's getting an early start to go after the band of mature rams he spotted last night.
High expectations this morning, knowing that you're actually maybe potentially going after something. But I'm sure we'll have to find them again this morning. All righty, I'm gonna hike up about an hour and see if we can't find those rams from last night. All right, I've hiked up into 12 Mile. I didn't see the rams over there this morning, so this is kind of bowl number 3 in 12 Mile. And this is kind of like when the pressure's on, this is kind of where they like to go. Sure enough, I found them. I can't approach them now. I'm gonna get above them up on this ridge by this snow patch up here. And I'm gonna wait them out and see what they do. The rams are just below me here. Probably about 200 yards. We're just gonna wait it out and see what happens.
After only a couple hours, Mother Nature spoils Chris's hunt again. Chris must give up on the rams and hope to try again tomorrow. Unfortunately, the next day brings more of the same.
Cloud formation this morning at 6 o'clock is usually what it is at about 3 o'clock in the afternoon, so usually it's not a good sign when you already got rain clouds at this early in the morning.
Chris decides to hike up higher to see if there might be a break in the weather.
Everything above tree line is really socked in and the visibility is almost zero. No sense in hiking all the way up to 13, just not be able to do anything. I mean, this is a spot and stalk hunt, and if you can't spot, you're not hunting. So, plus, you know, the exposure, being up that high and rain all day and this kind of stuff and slippery rocks. Well, my heart wants to go up there, but my head's telling me not to, so. We're gonna head back to camp.
Chris wakes up to nicer weather, but a light dusting of snow remains from the previous day's storm.
Summertime in Colorado.
Chris makes the long hike back to where he left the bedded rams 2 days before, hoping they're still in the area.
There they are.
We're on them again, baby.
The rams appear to be feeding up the draw in his direction. He quickly gets low and stalks closer.
Rams are about 200 yards. If I could just get up here another 50 yards. All right, they're about 100 yards out.
Oh no. I gut shot him. Mother. I made a horrible, horrible shot. It's sad. I mean, I'm sick right now. Just sick. And I'm praying right now we get that ram because he's a beautiful animal and he doesn't deserve this kind of. This is not the way pure hunting's supposed to work.
He's not hurting as bad as I thought he was.
The Stick and Lick is a revolutionary screw-in deer attractant utilizing the power of apples, caramel, and whole grains. The patented weather shield protects the attractant from snow and rain, allowing it to last months, not weeks, making it perfect for trail camera scouting. Get ready for the shot with Extreme Hunting Solutions. 8 seconds is all it takes to go from zero to invisible. The patented single-hub technology expands and retracts the rugged light-speed frame, offering the hunter an unsurpassed 280-degree field of view. The Light Speed Razor Blind by Ameristep. Cut your setup time to the bone.
Pure Hunting is brought to you by Winchester, the American legend. Spot Hog, the world's toughest archery products. Smith Optics, inside every warrior is an athlete. ESP, your hearing matters. And Nose Jammer. Not a cover set, not an attractant. Jam 'em with Nose Jammer. The Black Rat. Sound like $2 fighting, only from Flextone. The Wedge by Extreme Hunting Solution. Positions your trail camera properly every time. And by these fine sponsors.
It's day 6 of Chris's hunt, and he's just made a poor shot on a ram that hasn't gone down yet.
Well, shot at a really nice ram. Unfortunately, I made a horrible, horrible shot. And the mistake I made is I didn't look at my bubble. It ran off. About 150 yards from off, they're kind of standing, just milling around. I hope that we get this ram. No animal deserves a gut shot. It's probably gonna be a very, very long night for me.
Chris stays hidden, watching the ram until the clouds roll in and he can't see it anymore.
Well, it's been about an hour and we had some weather move in. Last we saw, the ram was bedded down in the same spot. We're gonna back out and come back in the morning.
Chris called Brad last night with the news of his shot, and Brad dropped everything to come up for the day to help recover the ram.
Yeah, right up there. Moment of truth, huh?
Yeah.
I'm sitting on the ridge.
Better ram.
Oh, is that him?
Dark chocolate, big and heavy. It's gotta be him.
That's him, Brad. I'll have to put a stalk on there and try to get another arrow in him.
This is the time to make the move.
Yes.
You move around. I'll be up there.
Brad gains elevation and heads to a ridge where he can see the ram and be a spotter to guide Chris in. But as Chris comes over the ridge, the ram bolts up the opposite hill. All Chris can do is watch as the ram disappears into the trees.
He's not hurting as bad as I thought he was. He just went about a half mile.
Brad joins back up with Chris and they devise a plan for the remainder of the day. Unfortunately, they can't locate the ram before sundown. Brad could only help for the one day, so Chris called some other friends who were able to join him for what he hopes is a recovery effort.
Paul, Chris, Joey, thanks for dropping everything in, coming up and helping me today. So,
anything we can do.
We chased that sheep all day yesterday, all day. And the last we saw him was right down in here. So I think if we just kind of spread out a little bit, you know, start doing circles. The last spot's right over here. Let's see if we can't go get ourselves a sheep.
The guys do a grid search in the trees where Chris last saw the ram in the hopes that he hasn't left the area.
Chris! Here he is!
Where are
you? Right here! Chris!
Yeah!
Oh,
him!
Good job!
Oh, that boy, buddy.
Good
job.
Look at that. Nice!
Good job.
Nice!
Nice chocolate.
Everybody get a hand.
Everybody
get a hand.
And I think the cape's still good. I mean, he's not that stiff yet, so. No. This has been two sleepless nights and three of the longest days of my life.
And how many years?
And how many years? 13 years.
13 years.
I wasn't proud of the shot, but I sure was proud of the recovery effort. First sheep hunt ever.
It was a good one, guys.
Thank you.
This hunt will go down as an all-time favorite. It truly shows the highs and lows of hunting. The weather was challenging, and even after all of his scouting efforts, Chris had difficulty finding sheep. There may be others who wouldn't have put forth that kind of effort into a recovery, so I'm proud of Chris and thrilled with the result. Although I couldn't join the hunt, I was excited to be able to meet him afterwards to hear the stories and help him with processing the meat. This is a big part of hunting for me. The friends, the stories, the camaraderie, and being able to introduce the next generation to our passion for the outdoors.